Hey everybody, it's Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe, and what I'm going to show you today is how to create a design layout using Adobe Stock, and we can actually take these images and we can try out different images without having to purchase them. I'm going to cover a few different things in this tutorial. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to find the images you want from directly within Photoshop. Then I'm going to show you some of the more advanced features on the Adobe Stock site for searching and sifting through millions of photos to find the ones you want. Then I'm going to show you how to create a layout right here inside of Photoshop where you can try out different images and see what you like. And then finally, if you choose to use it in the end, I'm going to show you how to license those images. All right, so let's get started. What we're going to do is we're going to do some kind of a design based on travel. So what we want to do is we're just going to open up our library panel. So you're just going to go under Window and you're going to choose the Libraries. Now this will be in CC only. If you have Photoshop CS6 and you don't have CC or a different version, you can go directly to the Adobe Stock site. So just move forward into the tutorial. But what we're going to do is we're going to do Exotic Location. That sounds like a pretty good thing to be searching for. So we just type that in there. Now what we can do, we can drag the library off, and if you really want to have a good look, we can drag it out like this and change the size of it, and we can scroll through and find some different types of locations. Now if you're finding something that's sort of looking like what you want, like maybe this is kind of cool, you can right click and you can choose Find Similar. And then what it's going to do now is it's going to update with all these similar types of photographs. So we've got these really cool kind of waterfalls and things like that. All right, so what if we just want to kind of maybe try one in our design? I'm just going to close this down a little bit. This is pretty cool, so we're just going to drag this in here, and we're just going to resize it to fit. So I'm just going to hold down the Shift key and drag it out till it fits on my screen. Hit Enter, and then we've kind of got this little bit of a mock-up. So what I've done is I've created a few things on here, just a little mock-up. So I've created some text here, a little quote, and then I just made a logo, Escargo Travel. Okay. We can try different types. So what we can do is we can right click here and we can choose to view details on web. So now we're going to go into the Adobe Stock site. So let me just bring that up here where we have more options. So we can see here, this is what we have. This is the image we were looking at. And click on there and you can look at the different photos from that particular series, and we can see that they are there. We're just going to click on Show More, and we can see, hey, there's different photos from this location. Now there's other things that we can do. Let's look at the option. So if we go up under Filter here, why don't we put in Exotic Location? So we're just going to hit on there and it's going to show us our locations. Now let's hit on the filtering. So under the filtering here, what we can do is we can choose to just use photographs. And notice that there's vectors and illustrations as well. Those are available. So what we can do is let's change it to, we only want to show things here in our landscape mode. And you know what, I want to have one with some people in there because I feel like for travel, it just makes it feel a little better with some people. So what we can do is we can click on Update now. Okay, so here we go. So we can scroll down now. We can see, you know, hey, we've got some different people in here that are enjoying themselves. Maybe we want to see more of someone sitting on the beach. So we can select that. Just click Find Similar. And now here we go. We've got more people sitting on the beach. So that's kind of cool. Well, what if you wanted something different, though? You know, like maybe you want a particular color. We can actually go under here. And then if we choose, you know, something like, I don't know, we've got different types of colors here. We could choose maybe a red, and then we're going to update this. And now we're going to see just our travel ones with those red colors. See that? You know, we could change the color to something else, such as a green. And then we can make sure travel's there. Hit update. And now we're going to see stuff with more of a green background. Maybe more of an aqua kind of a color. That looks nice. Let's update that. And of course, this is going to take us to these beautiful aqua waters. So you can see that. We've got these travel shots now with this beautiful water. And maybe we can find something, you know, that's a little bit more that kind of a style. So we could go there. And of course, we could choose more from this model or more from this series. This series here, shows more from that particular shot. So a lot of the time it's, you know, the same photographer. So it can give you a similar photograph from, you know, maybe a different perspective or a different angle. And the other option we could do here is, you know, if we just want to click here, and we could see here, we can see, you know, more from this model. So we can see, you know, maybe you like that person that they're using, and we can see the other pictures where that particular model is featured. All right, so let's try something a little bit different. Let's try our travel. And let's add a second keyword. We're going to do travel and we're going to do city. For the color, is let's grab something more in the kind of a brownish kind of color. So it's going to give us a little bit more urban. And now we're going to hit update. And here we go. Now we've got travel more in that kind of location. Okay, there's another way that we can search too. And that's we can upload our own photos. So if I click here, I can actually upload a photo. So let me find a photograph that I have. And here I've got this boat and the took myself. So why don't we just choose this? And now we're going to let it search based on that. And here we go. So now it shows similar images to that particular image of mine. Okay, maybe something like this here might tell our story quite well. So what we want to do is we want to use this photo. So what we're going to do now is we're going to download this into Photoshop. So what we do is we click on here and notice it says save preview to photos because that's the library item that I have selected. But if we click on here, these are the different libraries that I've created. And so I could just pull this into one of the existing ones. Or if I want, I could create a new library. Let's just call it travel. And we're going to hit plus there. And it's going to create that library right now. And it's going to save that. Notice it says now it's saved to there. So under Photoshop, let's go down to the travel. And there's our photograph right there. So why don't we take this? We're going to drag that in. And let's resize it. Hit enter. And you can see that we've kind of looked at it and it's kind of looks pretty good. Maybe we'll do something with our Wanderlust. Maybe we'll let's try a soft light there with maybe an effect in there. So let's put in a little bit of a shadow. Let's put a drop shadow in there. And we can just drag that drop shadow around, notice. Now let's bring the opacity down a little bit, just so it kind of shows through a little bit. All right, so we're just adding a little bit more. All right, so why don't I just do another little thing? I'm just going to create a gradient. So I'm going to create a new layer here. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to grab a black, the transparent gradient. I'm just going to kind of pull it up a little bit. There we go, at the bottom there. And resize that text. Let's just move it around a little bit, just so it kind of shows through a little bit. In fact, let's bring the opacity down a little so it's not quite so dark. There we go. And at this point here, let me just resize that. So I just hit Control T, by the way, for free transform, or that would be Command T on Mac. And I'm just dragging the corner down and just to make it fit. So I'm just going to drag it down there. That looks nice. All right. So at this point here, if you decide that you want to use this, you know, you could show it to your client or whatever, or just for yourself, and you want to license that image, then all we need to do is we just right click on here and choose license image. Okay, so at this point here, you know, you can have a subscription to Adobe Stock or you can buy the images one at a time if you want to replace this with the unwatermarked version. Also have a look at the link underneath there and it'll give you a link to this particular image on my website also where there's some offers that you can get 10 free images from Adobe Stock. So let's click OK. And you can see what's happening right now. It updates and now it replaces it with the high resolution version. So you'll notice the quality increased nicely and the watermark disappeared. So if we look right there, we have completed our design. So there we go. That's how we create a layout using Adobe Stock. Now, this is something I wish I'd had 10 years ago, because I just remember how difficult it was to find the right images, even for making mockups and different things like that. And especially finding the last image. I remember back in the day, don't laugh at me, when we used to have to buy bulk CDs. We'd buy all these image CDs and DVDs and we'd sift through them, and it was very difficult. But now it's very easy to try out the different images, to search and locate the photo that you want. So anyway, if you like this video, hit the subscribe button. I do a new tutorial every single week in Photoshop and Lightroom, different types of gadgets. Also, hit that like button right now. I really appreciate it. And add a comment. If you have any questions or any comments, let's get the discussion going. So thanks for watching. Until next week, I'll see you at the cafe.